flip that script. That's where the guest gets to ask the host a question. I don't know what you're going to ask.
This is a tough one.
Okay. I still laugh at that. Flip the script. It's time. I got Gene and Linda with me, just so you all know in the listening audience what this means. Usually the host is asking the guest questions and questions and questions, but the guests never get to ask the host question. This is a segment in which I'm going to bear myself out and allow Linda and Gene to ask the great questions that they always do. So I will start ladies first. Hashtag Jersey Girl. Linda, flip that script.
Okay. All right. Admissible or inadmissible?
Law school gives you four choices.
I know we're to the surprise of everybody in the chat room. We're only going to talk about Bautista, okay? If you were the prosecutor or the defense, which one? Let's say the defense, and you wanted to do a stand-up. Now, what is a stand-up? You bring somebody the size of Mo Knight in and let your client stand up next to somebody who's the size of Mo Light, would you rule it admissible or inadmissible if you were the judge? And would you do it if you were the prosecutor or defense?
In that question, you got me being a prosecutor, a defense lawyer, a judge.
You are the man.
I am, as a judge, let me start with that.
Okay.
I do not like recreations that aren't necessarily recreating the scene. They have the pictures, they have the evidence. It could lead to undue confusion in my mind under Rule 403, and I'd probably be inclined not to do it. Now, as a defense attorney, if I think it helps in order to show it, I'm going to try to get away with whatever I could. As a prosecutor, I certainly don't want that. I'm going to be objecting to the admission of that kind of evidence.
Oh, because it's bad evidence for you.
Well, because it could lead to confusion, and it isn't replicating necessarily the scene.
If you stand up on this table, and you're like 7'4" and I'm like 5'7", that's kind of a good demo.
But that demo is not evidence. The evidence is in the case. They have all that information. So again, under that evidence rule, 403 in most places where the undue prejudice outweighs the probative value of that evidence, I have not seen many courts that allow demonstrations like that occur. Although, if I were down in Texas or Louisiana or places like that, probably anything that they want to do, the prosecution at least, is going to get through. All right, Gene Rossi, flip that script on me.
Oh, that was a good question.
Thank you, Gene.
Let's go back to Lisa Cruz in trial prep. How would you approach, sir, preparing somebody by like Lisa Cruz, the crime scene person, to make her testimony a little better than it came out? What would you have done as a prosecutor?
Yeah, that's a great question, Gene, because this can really make or break a case, a witness like this. And if that person didn't do something that they were supposed to do, or irrespective of that, the evidence person is going to be in my office with my detective, and we're going to go through every single piece of evidence, what was done, what wasn't done. Listen, no investigation is pristine. There's always something that they're going to make a mistake with. I at least want them to have an answer that is going to be better than I don't recall. Now, many times the reason these investigators are making a mistake is when they're processing the crime scene, there's a lot of data and information that is later developed that they did not know about and didn't think that it was necessarily going to be relevant, or it could be just complete malfeasance. Either way, I got to get them to own up to it as quickly as possible. Otherwise, defense lawyers like you and me and Linda are going to make them look like worse than them doing a bad job. They're going to make them look completely incompetent. Great question. Questions, guys. I love it. Thank you so much always for the Flip That Script. Long Crime Network. We'll be right back.